Just. Has he left the shot?
We're back on.
We're back on, yeah.
Yeah, sorry about that, peeps. We are back on now. I don't know what happened there. No. Everything seemed fine at our end, but obviously it wasn't working for whatever reason. But
there
we're
0% dropped frames.
We're cooking with gas.
Oh, we're flying here. We're flying.
Just let us know on the chat how you're getting on, please.
Needs to go past that, Mark. Needs to go past that. Oh, he's unlucky there.
Yeah, it's still 3-0, mate. Yeah, yeah.
Just give a quick score update from table 12. A cheeky little side game for £100 a man. Samhurst gave Matt Schofield from Halifax 2 start to 15 and lost 15-11.
Right then.
Idiot.
Must be touching ball this, Danny. It looks to be playing safe.
Yeah,
I'm not sure whether the ref's called
it.
Presume the ref is.
That's not the worst shot in the world, Mark.
Can he not see that? Yeah, Rick, Sam lost 15-11. Players are just having a little bit of a chat off camera. I'm not sure what it's about. Wow, what a great shot.
It's a great shot, Matt.
Shot to nothing, mate.
Yeah, I mean,
Lee shouldn't have left it, to be fair.
It's a very, very, very tough shot now to get back on the next yellow, on his last yellow, unless he plays the plant. And the plant's a very tough shot.
You've got to play the plant, unless he can see. I don't think he can see the bottom one of the two, to be honest.
I've got a funny feeling he might be able to.
Nah, I don't think. I think he can see it, but not to pot it.
Looks like he's going for the plant, Mark.
I think you've got to go for the plant, mate, to be fair. Oh, has he got lucky?
Oh,
wow, man.
Wowee.
Lee taps... Oh, Jack taps the table.
Some crowd in here tonight, Mark, lad.
Yeah, we can't, obviously, moderate all this foul language by the crowd. That unfortunately, yeah, that is going to happen.
We apologise for any... You know, if there's any sort of youngsters watching, there's nothing we can do. We've got a microphone above the table, so you can hear the balls getting potted, so you can hear maybe the players' interaction with each other and the players' interaction with themselves. But there's not much we can really do about the fans, I'm afraid.
No, well, to be honest with you, Danny, I aren't telling it to shut up because there's more of them than there is me.
Yeah, by about 100 times.
Oh. I'm surprised at that, Danny. I'm surprised he's missed that, to be fair.
I'm very surprised at that.
Just a note as well, just black ball rules, 2 shots do not carry. Just to remind the world
snooker,
rule viewers. Yeah, still a total snooker as normal, but the 2 shots don't carry. So you'll probably see Jack just knock a red, what he's doing there, knocking the red safe. using one of his two to knock the red safe rather than just... So, perfect start for Jack. I mean, he's obviously had a role there. Lee's been a bit unfortunate, but... 4-0.
He holds his hand up there, Mark, and he apologised at the end of the frame.
Yeah, it's good sportsmanship.
It is. I mean, you know, Lee will know that, obviously, he's got very lucky there as Jack with a snooker. Because if he doesn't get the snooker, Lee wins the frame.
Yeah, and it's 3-1, different game. You know, Lee's got his first frame on the board and he settles down a little bit.
Hey, Lunny. I know how to pick these players, don't I?
Steady away, like.
Decent. And that's Jack's break, and them Reds look decent again.
Tasty.
Do you know, playing like this, Mark, I am, and I mean this in the greatest of respect. How was Liam beaten?
Nah, it's different, isn't it?
Of course it is. A race to five.
Tournament different. Scenario, race to five, different to a 14 grand money match.
Someone's asking in the chat where the stream's gone. The stream is absolutely fine at our end. We're actually watching it as well as streaming it, so there's no problem there. Maybe restart your browser, change to a different browser.
Great cue ball control from Jack there.
Yes.
Needs to get a decent angle on the one in the middle now, and that's the only stumbling block. I actually think he's played on the one to the middle there, right then, actually.
Yeah, I don't think the one to the right-hand side of the table goes in the top, does it?
No. He's going to have to play that in the middle. That's why I think he's played on it now, because that is not an ideal ball to be getting shape on that last red.
No, not at
so,
all.
So, you know, he's still got some work to do here. I think if he comes round off two rails from this one, he may be able to pot that red in the middle and come round three rails for the red in the bottom right-hand corner. It all depends on whether he's got the right angle to be able to avoid that yellow that he's closest to. A little bit of left-hand side.
If I think where he is now, Mark, he's absolutely perfect. I think he can avoid the yellow and he can come round three rails.
Yeah.
Just sort of land where he is now. I don't think he needs to play
this one. He's screwing back.
Or he could just do that and land perfect.
Yeah, no, that's perfect. Good control with the screw.
Fantastic
there.
Fantastic control there. Looks like we're saying to be fair a lot, Mark.
To be fair, it was right. I think Mr. Whelan's fans are going to be chanting too easy again.
Mm. I do feel an easy chant coming on.
That a break run, Mr. Byrne?
There we go.
That's a break run.
Jack will know that if Lee hits a gear, Lee can just reel off five frames as well.
Yeah, to be honest with you, mate, the five nil start here, it's I wouldn't say it's irrelevant because he's definitely not, but it's it in the status of the match, a five frame lead in the first five frames doesn't really mean a great deal.
Sorry to interrupt you, Matt. These reds look nice.
These reds look gorgeous, and I would be highly surprised if he doesn't get these.
I'd fancy getting these, Matt. So Lee should.
Obviously, he needs to get his first frame on the board, and that's possibly the only thing that
he could really do with that.
Could do with this British to get his first frame on.
Not just to get his first frame on, but for the bit of confidence. The club owner's here. He's just joined us, Dave. A few words for the fans.
Yes, it's good to be here. It's a really good atmosphere, and there's a lot of banter between the fans. And if they get out of order, I'm going to wang them down the steps.
And there's a lot of bloody steps, I'll tell you.
Quality. Legend, Big Dave. Yeah, nice shot from Lee. I mean, he hasn't got the greatest of angles on this ball on the right-hand side of the table, but so I think he probably will be able to just drop this in and hold for the two over the bottom left-hand corner pocket. If not, he can screw and hold it on the yellow. Well, he has tried holding it on the yellow, but he's missed the red in the process.
He's looking nervy, Mark.
Yeah, I mean, like I said, Danny, I think until he gets his first frame on the board, and that'll settle him down a lot.
I can see Paul Maguire stood on chairs. I can see Jack's fans stood on chairs. It's fantastic.
Yeah, it's great stuff.
As long
mate.
As they don't ruin the chairs, that is.
They can ruin as many chairs as they like.
Yeah, absolutely.
Nah, it's good to see an atmosphere like this, mate.
He might struggle to get out of this one.
Yeah. I think the rattle in the jaws and play it long is the shot, yeah. I don't see how else he can get out of this.
Yeah, I'm not sure how else he can get out of this, Mark, but his queuing's terrible, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, he's bridging over the yellow. He's not got a great deal of chance. I think he's got to try rattle it in the jaws, me. Because the black's in the way of the two or three cushion escape for the two reds that's on the top left of the screen. So I think the rattle in the jaws is possibly the only shot here, Mr. Byrne.
It's really tough. It's really tough, is this one.
Unless you can play it into the rail with straight into the right-hand side rail with some screw to straighten it up off the cushion. But I don't think that's on, to be honest. He's trying to screw it and straighten it up off the rail. He's changing his mind. Very tricky, this. He knows that if he don't get out of this, he's probably going to go 6-0 down. That's the last thing he was hoping.
This is let's be honest, Matt. I know you said earlier that 5-0 in the first five frames. Thanks, Dave. 5-0 in the first five frames isn't massive. But to go 6-0 down,
I think it's big, but I don't think it's as it's obviously not as big as a 10-4 lead. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, because he's at 10. But I think to go 6-0 down, Mark. Yeah. I mean, he's gone for your shot, and it's a valid attempt, in fairness.
Yeah, there's not a lot else he could have done there, to be fair, mate. I mean, I think he'll take the white here and try to disturb that situation at the bottom left-hand side of the table.
Would you, right, here, in your personal opinion, would you play the straight plant with the yellow onto it, or would you play...
I'd play this yellow on the left-hand side onto the red, yeah, in off the other red.
Yeah.
That's what I'd be playing. But he's obviously putting the red over the bottom right and screwing into the bottom left.
See, what I was thinking is the one near the yellow, near the middle pocket, could you play that off the red that's closest? Jack's obviously going to go for another snooker here then, would you say?
Unless he's playing a yellow in off the red, but I mean, if he were going for the finish, then you'd imagine him to open that situation up straight away. I don't know, I'm a little bit confused with that, to be honest.
Yeah, he's going for a snooker in here.
Looks like he is, but I think he's going to do well not to pot this, Danny, if he goes for the snooker. The angle he's got, I think he's going to do well not to pot the ball over the back. No, it looks like he's just going to double this one down and sit the white where it is now. Well, he might be going for it.
End of day, Mark. He's 5-0 up. He might as well go for it.
Yeah, I mean, I don't see it like that, personally.
I mean, yeah, see, now yeah,
he's played that okay.
He's left Lee a chance, because Lee can go across.
Off the back of it. No, I'd come off the back of this. If you come off the back rail, let me just draw this. If you come off the back rail, we're right hand side.
You can't miss the red.
The red is going to go in off the red and free up that whole situation. Isn't it? So I think that's a shot, maybe.
The only thing I'm thinking, Mark, is if he plays up to it, yeah.
No, he is playing your shot, Danny. Fair enough. I mean, it's not the worst shot in the world, is it?
Yeah, he's...
Puts him favourite.
Yeah, Jack doesn't have a shot to speak of, and... yeah.
That guy who didn't have sound, he had his phone on silent. Yeah, that could be one.
Jack needs a good shot here, to be fair. He needs to cover the red with the black, really. That's probably what he's looking at.
So that's all he's got? Unless he can manoeuvre the cue ball back over to the top left-hand corner pocket.
I'm not sure he can. Because, I mean...
Unless he hits that yellow we can see, like, half ball, and plays it with, like, dragon left, and spins it off that right-hand side cushion to get it up there.
Yeah, I think the problem there, Mark, is that the fact that he's moving the yellow, that's covering the reds.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So he's going to leave
like
it
say,
either
he's,
way.
He's going to play your shot. He's going to just cover it with the black. I think he's hit that too hard. He's caught the jaw.
He's caught the nut. He's not played that great, so.
No, but he can't see the back one of the two.
No, but he can see the top one. So he's.
Does the top one plant onto it, though?
Yeah, he can, yeah, yeah.
No, it doesn't look like it from the front angle, but it does from the side. He's made it. He's played your shot. Didn't want the double kiss like that, though. I mean,
yeah, he's a little unfortunate there. He really is. I think it still pots.
Yeah, it does. Yeah, yeah. I actually think it's easier than it looks on our screens.
Yeah, I think it is.
He's going to have to get a rest here.
I think he's doing right. Just take his time a little bit. He needs to get the first frame on the board.
Going to cover it with a black.
No. It's not. An easy shot now for Jack to make it hard.
Here's a question for you. If it's an impossible shot, a black ball, is it a re-rack?
It must be.
Oh, what a shot that is. What a shot that is.
Absolutely awesome shot that is.
He has covered the across to perfection.
That is...
How can you even see that? How can you even see to play that shot?
Talent is that, Mark.
That is just ridiculous.
That's different gravy, mate. He's going to have to play it with loads of side.
That's the angle he's going to have to take, at least.
And to be honest, Mark, I honestly don't think he can get it with that in the yellow. No, you can't. Someone's asking in the chat if you can deliberate foul in black ball. You cannot.
That's the only way you can get this, because the black's in the way of the two or three cushion escape. That's literally the only way he can get this. That's the minimum angle he's got to take. He might even elect to go a little bit higher than where I've put that line.
Yeah, he's not going behind that yellow, is he?
He can't go
behind that yellow. Don't go. He don't go, Mark. It does go.
It does go.
It does go. What a shot.
That is a great shot.
He deserves that.
To get your first frame on the ball, that is unbelievable.
That's got to be a confidence builder, that has.
I did not think that went at all.
A great shot. I think we'll hear a massive applause here. I've got to tap the table for that, Mark.
Yeah, I didn't even think that went, mate, honestly.
I didn't think that went on. I said before they cued it, that's not on. It was on. I'm just going to nip to the toilet.
Decent break from Jack again. I think he'll end up going yellow, do you? I think that situation at the top left-hand side of the table probably lends to yellows a little bit better than he does reds. I mean, reds wouldn't be the bad choice. He can use the right hand most of the three reds in the bark area to free up the other two. And I actually think the middle one of the three passes into the left-hand corner. As you see from that camera angle, the rightmost of the three there, I think that just passes. So, in fact, he'll probably go red here, because he's got that bit of insurance that the red over the bottom left-hand corner. So I think he'll take one to the left middle first, and go up to bark area to play the rest of them, hopefully get them out. Yeah, that's what he's done. I mean, obviously he can go crashing into these, and if he does pot a yellow, it's not a problem. Black ball rules, of course, you can play the skill shot. So pot this and go crashing into these balls. Hope it comes out smelling roses. Well, it did pass, as you can see. So does that red pass? Yeah, that red passes into that corner, so need a decent shot to land on this if he's going to try to elect to just play on it. May elect to cannon it out, and I'm not sure, but if I were him, I'd be playing on it. It's got about 6 inches. Not much. 6 inches to work with here.
Have a missed out, Mark.
This is a jack on the break dish. He's got about 6 inches to work with.
This isn't an easy shot to avoid this yellow.
He
can play it in, because it's black ball, he can play it in a way he could actually pot the yellow.
I think he's missing the yellow on the way there.
You think so?
I think he'll hit it on the way back, not on the way there.
On the way back up?
Yeah, yeah.
On the way back up, it's very dangerous.
Yeah, it is, because you can end up hitting the right-hand yellow, full in the face and snookering yourself. He's just got to trust this to a little bit of luck, unfortunately. I think he's on it.
He's played it decent enough, hasn't he?
Yeah, he's on it. Pretty sure he's on it.
Yeah. You say that's for the break dish, is it, Mark?
That's a break dish.
And that's 3-0 on the break dish stakes. Take it out off to Jack so far, Mark. He's maybe played. Well, he hasn't played a slack shot yet, has he? But in fact, the one.
He's played that one yellow into the corner bag. Yeah, that were it.
That is a
nice break from Lee.
Fucking fantastic break. Wow, that is a great break, Mark.
That 3-0. That 3-0 on the British front could all of a sudden be 3-1.
Could be completely different in a second, Mark. Yeah. He's got to be going yellows here, hasn't he?
Yeah, yeah, no danger. But the two reds on the right-hand side table are a bit of insurance just in case he misses as well.
The daft thing is, Mark, if Lee does miss these yellows, it's so easy to get them reds out. From where the reds are, you play the one on the left-hand side. But I absolutely do not expect Lee to be missing these. Not a player of Lee's calibre.
No, I mean, I'm not. I think he's tried playing on the top one there, has he not?
No, I don't think so.
Oh, he can play on that one. He can use it as his last ball, can't he? He'll use the one over the right middle as his second last ball, and the one over the top right as his last ball, I would think. Yeah, he's played that well. Nice angle. Just run up for the.
I think he's going to play on it after this one.
No, I'd play the bottom one here. I'd play the bottom one, then the left-hand side one, then the right-hand side one. Then the top right, and then the black in the middle.
I just think he's absolutely perfect on the one in the middle to just, yeah.
I think your cue ball travels much more distance going this way.
It does. I totally.
And you run the risk of running behind the reds on the right hand side. If you play for the black in the left middle, you run that risk. But obviously, he's going to play for the black in the top right corner.
And he's got to get half decent on this last ball, man. On this next ball, he's got to get well. He's got to get pretty good, to be honest.
Yeah, he's got to be pretty straight, hasn't he?
He'll take that.
Yeah, that's perfect. It just stunned this in.
Yeah, it could have done with being a little bit closer, like a bit closer towards the black. Nah. It won't matter to someone like Lee.
No, I disagree. I don't mind leaving myself a long shot.
Nah, if you're confident in your potting, you don't mind at all. Lee's confident in his potting, so. Will we see him go for the black in the?
I reckon top right,
bottom left, bottom right as well.
Bottom right as we look, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah. He's left himself a tiny bit too straight on this, Mark. Or can he just belt this in and then put the white off the rail?
No, he just punch it in with a bit of right hand side, yeah. And he'll be there. Well, it must go in the top. It must go in the top right then. If that's the case,
it can't do.
No, it doesn't.
It can't do.
He's played for that in the left middle, don't
he? He has, hasn't he?
And you run the risk of going behind those reds as well. That's the wrong choice of shot.
Queuing confidently.
The in-offs on here.
Off the red.
Yeah! Nice, played it well.
Top of the table from me and Mark.
6-2 and Lee's that's first break dish of the match.
Come on, We've not seen Jack go anywhere near a pocket from a break, have we?
No, he's screwing that cue ball straight back up into the ball. Some guys in the chat going mad. Some Ainsley Daniels is trying to back Lee for a grand.
Yeah. Ooh. Little bit of a slap on from Jack.
Yeah, he was trusting to a little bit of luck, wasn't he?
He was hoping that, obviously, he wasn't expecting to sit on the black. And he was expecting to maybe be on the next red, but... From here, I make Lee favourite because I can't really... unless he gets this double.
Which he does. Oh, no.
Ooh.
Yes, Popski, there is about 130, 120 here. What do you say?
Yeah,
100.
Yeah, about 100. About 100 here, mate.
100
yeah.
here. Yeah.
There's yeah, it's a great atmosphere. Pup. It's a shame you can't make it, to be fair. I know you've just bought an house, and I wish you all the best in that venture, son.
Well, what's Haswell played there? Sorry, we're just being preoccupied saying some goodbyes to Ryan Driver, and all of a sudden we come back to the table on Lee Snookwood. Didn't see that.
It's Lee at the table.
He must have put himself there, Dan.
I think he can clip the bottom one. Is he looking? I'll be honest, I wasn't watching the shot.
No, I weren't.
Someone
either.
Were leaving, so yeah. I was saying bye, but yeah. That's not a great shot. Now, if Lee can clip the bottom one, the one that's on the rail, he's not. It can come off the right hand side cushion as we're looking. Hang on, seen something.
In off the red in the bottom left. He's
seen.
He's played it.
Hang on.
He's opened everything up for
7-2.
Jack. He's opened it all up, hasn't he?
I'm going to say 7-2 here, Mark. I'll stick my neck on the line.
Whoa, you live dangerously, you, pal.
It's not a dangerous leave, is it? Not with someone like Jack.
No. I think he's had a bit of a kick there.
I don't think it'll matter, do you?
Nah, it don't matter. Wheeling too good for this geezer.
Oh, that's a good ass, is that?
You wish he is unique. You hope he is, you mean.
No, genuinely, Eric, Lee is a fantastic player, he really is.
He wouldn't be playing the match for £7,000 a man if he won.
No, not at all, mate. And he knows Jack, and he assured me he was more than confident playing Jack, so, I mean...
At the end of the day, he wouldn't be here if he weren't confident.
No, absolutely.
And he wouldn't be getting the back in if his backers weren't confident.
No.
He obviously knows the game.
No, he won't at all, Mark, you're right. Now, Eric says he's seen him play a few times and he says Jack's far too good for him. That's fair enough if he's seen Lee play. I didn't think there were much in it, I really didn't.
Yeah, he just cues the ball so well, doesn't he? He just cues the ball so straight, he just never looks like missing.
to be fair, Matt, I mean, obviously you've played him at, you played him for money at Nine Ball.
Yeah, did you?
And there weren't many times where he looked like missing at all, were there?
No, he did. He beat me 21-15. He played well, like.
You had a decent lead at one point. He's early on.
No, that was in the Michael Rhodes match.
Oh, that was Michael Rhodes, sorry, yeah.
He outpointed me, simple as that. There's not many people that have been doing that to me when I played for cash at that time.
That's what can happen at Nine Ball, Matt. You know yourself. Obviously, if you're a very, very good player. Mark didn't hear a word I said there.
Didn't hear a word of that, Danny.
All I was saying, Mark, is that at Nine Ball, that's what can happen.
Yeah, without a doubt, mate, without a doubt.
You know, the better potter doesn't always win, but, you know, we all, me and you always say it's not all just about potting Nine Ball, which it isn't at all, but it bloody helps, doesn't it?
No, mate, I honestly can stand here and honestly say that when I go into a Nine Ball game, I'm not really worried about how many balls I pot. It's more about how well I play the safety in the rest of the game, because, you know, if me and you both play our best game, probably neither of us is going to miss. So
no, true.
The emphasis is more on the safety. I know we don't want to get into this. Don't want to get into this situation.
No, not at all.
Into this conversation, but yeah, no, it's obviously Jack's a great player. All Q Sports.
We're just being told in the chat, Mark, that it has to be physically impossible to get out of a snooker, but there is a re-rack.
Yeah. Well, that's what I presume, because obviously there's no deliberate foul rule.
It's similar to EPA.
It's the exact
obviously.
Same as EPA rules. Yeah. That's how I presumed anyway.
I presume the same. Obviously, we weren't sure.
And great break from Lee once again.
Would you say he's
going to
be
down for this
leaving
red.
This bad ball on the bottom cushion till last?
No.
He can't. He don't want to, does he?
Don't want to, no. Because he's going to struggle to get back on the black if he does do that.
As easy as these reds look, Mark, they're not, are they?
They're not, no. I'm struggling to see how he's going to get down for that one on the bottom rail. If I were him, I'd honestly be tempted to go yellows.
If that bottom one's an inch off the cushion, these are easy.
I honestly tempted to go yellows here.
Oh yeah, I totally agree with you.
Play the one into the bottom left corner as we look.
He can play the one.
He's playing the back red of the bunch.
Nice.
He needs that black to get past.
Do you think he might look to play safe here? Maybe just knock the red down towards the bottom of the table.
Put the white behind the black.
And not so much. Yeah. He could put the white behind the black. He's obviously risking the in-off there.
You're not. It doesn't go. The in-off doesn't go.
If it hits the black, it's cushion, then black with the cue ball, it could go.
Oh, yeah, but you'd have to be a mile out for that to happen.
All I'm thinking is if he pushes the red down the bottom of the table and just puts the white in the middle of the top cushion. Just to the right of middle of the top cushion. Craig Day saying, Craig, I'm gonna disagree with you. I'm pretty sure most of Lee's backers will know Jack is he's a big name in 8 ball, Mark, isn't he?
He's a well known player, isn't he? There's no doubt about
that. That's a fantastic shot, you've called it, Mark.
he's found the gap. Interesting to see what Lee does here. Does he? If I'm Lee here, I just dolly this over the pocket, because obviously two shots don't carry.
Yeah, that's
there's
the
no
shot
point
for me,
trying
Matt.
To force this in and missing it.
No, that's the shot for me.
Dolly this red over the bin. Play the white up table. Yeah,
literally just tap it.
Well, he has. And that's the exact reason I would have dollied it over the bag.
You called it. Absolutely right, mate.
Yeah, that's the exact reason why I'd have dollied it over the bag. To be honest with you, Danny, I never thought I'd be saying this, but I think that shows a little bit of a lack of experience at the black ball rules. Does he play black ball like all the time?
Yeah, he doesn't play world rules anymore, Mark. And let's be honest, you don't get to the final of a main event on the IPA tour.
Oh no! I didn't mean that in any disrespect to Lee.
No, not at all.
It showed a little bit of inexperience.
That's a shot I would have played at black ball rules.
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
I've only played him once, and that was the shot.
You called the right shot as well. I mean, I would have played the same shot Lee did, but I would have thought about it a lot more, because Lee's a lot faster player than me, because he's probably a lot better than me.
Yeah.
Because he'll see
a the shot
a lot quicker than I will.
Yeah.
That's a lovely shot.
I mean, someone in the chat's just said Lee can't win.
Lee can
definitely win.
Most definitely win.
You know, you put any top player in this situation, and anyone can turn it on, can't they? In the right situation, you know, when you're playing at this level.
People were telling me that Stefan couldn't beat Ben Clayton. That's all I'll say.
People were telling some other people that
Elliot Glover couldn't beat Richard Pammant.
No, that Stefan couldn't lose to Ben.
Yeah.
It's just an opinion thing, yeah. I mean, there's absolutely no doubt about it that Lee can definitely win. I mean, end of day, one dry break and two break dishes.
It's three frames really quick.
That's Lee there, right there. I mean, I'm sure Lee won't mind me mentioning this. I beat him 4-0 in the semi-final of the Golden 8 Ball, and he had two shots, and one of them were both breaks.
If
I brought dish
well
twice, and he's missed in one, and dry broke the other.
If you break well, just one second. Yeah, it was 21-19 to Ben Clayton, people in the chat are asking. Not to Ben Clayton, to Stefan. Yeah, Mark, you know as well as I do, if you break well at black ball rules, if there's any sort of shot on.
It was in as well.
He's unlucky there.
He's covered
the
black.
Very unlucky there.
Has he covered the black?
I don't think he has.
No.
He's very unlucky there, because that were going in.
They're both the black and the yellow go.
Yeah, they do.
But yeah, Danny, I mean, just in a short period of time like that, Lee can win 4-0, 5-0 just the same as Jack won 4-0, 5-0 at the start of the match.
Of course he can.
In small blocks, that's why we're playing a race to 25, because in small blocks either player can do that.
Look when I played Marco Firth. I were 6-2 down, and I went 9-6 up within 6 frames, because I broke dish all of mine and he didn't pot off a break.
Yeah.
That's not me saying I'm good. I just played well, and black ball rules made me able to do that, because whilst I didn't break the best, there was a plant on, or there was a shot where I could pot something from another ball, so it meant I could break dish. Whereas at World Rules, completely different. You can't do that. You've got to nominate your colour. You don't have to nominate a black ball. It makes it so much easier. And I mean, you know, we've said that. I've said this all day, Mark. I'm not going to sit here and slay it. World Rules are all like that, because that's what I play. But black ball rules for me, so much more exciting, because the better player will win. At World Rules, still the better tactical player can win, but at Black Ball Rules, the better player,
whoever breaks best and pots best, will win.
Yeah, absolutely. I'm glad I didn't play Black Ball Rules last night against Gabriel, because he's battered me.
You're right.
He broke better and he potted better.
Exactly. Yeah.
My safety game was a lot better.
Obviously, this ball passes
this
to the bottom
goes,
right.
It looks. Looks close.
I mean, there's people shushing while Jack's on his shot, and Jack's just not bothered.
Not interested, is he?
Not bothered whatsoever. I don't even think he's hearing it.
Nah, probably not.
Danny Byrne v Gabe was 17-15 to Gabe. Good match. Enjoyed watching it.
I thoroughly enjoyed it. I really did. Gabe deserved to win. Anyway, enough about me. Someone's just asked in the chat who's talking. You got myself, Danny Byrne, and on you go, Mark.
I'm Mark Lunn, legend.
We.
Another big break from Jack. I think someone mentioned in the chat, Jack's break is huge. Jack's break is huge. Fantastic. Yes, mate, I played... who do you mean? I played Jack at nine ball probably a year and a half ago now, but I played Kev Simpson. I played Kev Simpson when I've been playing for like 2 weeks. He beat me 21-20. Then I played Jack a few months after that, after I'd, you know, getting that little bit more experience. He beat me as well. It's not gone well. But no, I've done all right since then. I lost to Jack for 1500 a man. Lost to Kev for 600 a man. I won a few more to counter that, so it's all good. Jack's looking at another break this year. This would be his fourth if he gets these. Let that one slip a little bit. Wanted to be on the one above the black. Yeah, mate, this is Mike Lunn on the commentary. I also beat Pupsky on MMTV, and Ollie won't remind you of that.
We both had a few decent victories on Money Match TV, haven't we, Lunny?
Not being funny, pal, but Jack Whelan's on his fourth break dish already.
Nice.
This is for break dish number four.
Frame time, 1 minute 16 so far. This is ridiculous, Mark.
Who are you, Cod Liver? Who's Cod Liver?
I'm in Germany.
Who is he though? I don't know who he is.
Yeah,
saying long time.
Give us your name, Luke Colliver.
I must be terrible with names or something. I don't remember a Luke Colliver.
Genuinely, I've never heard of him, mate. And I mean that obviously, no disrespect. I'm told Del Sim's watching us, Mark. He just can't log into the chat.
No, I don't remember your Colliver. Maybe I'm having a mind blank.
it's nice to see that Leeds fans aren't giving up. I'll just Rick Needham says he must be gashed his cod liver because no one knows him. Rick, I'll ask the question. Does he know you?
Well, Rick, the people know you and your gash, so how's that logic?
Yeah, that don't work, does it? This game could be over quicker than we thought, Mark.
You're welcome, Rick. Do you know what, Danny? I never saw Jack running away like this.
Nah, me neither. Honestly, I've genuinely never seen Jack play 8-ball. Seen him play 9-ball, obviously, against you.
To be honest, I haven't seen him play a great deal. I saw him play a little bit of golden 8-ball.
Hmm.
But apart from that, that's only just gone in.
The only thing I've seen of him, Mark, is when he lost to Liam Waterworth. And
obviously that's not his finest hour, no offense to Liam.
Not at all. It's probably Liam's finest hour. It's probably Liam's finest hour without a doubt. People saying Lee isn't in Jack's league on the chat room, Mark, and
not in current form, he's not.
That's not why right that, now
that's,
he's
that,
not.
That's
no.
why he's 9-2 behind. But any, like you say, Danny, any man that can get to an IPA Tour final that includes the likes of Gareth Potts in the tournament, then you know he's obviously a fantastic player, and people can't overlook that.
No,
Jack obviously doesn't play on the IPA Tour anymore. I don't think.
Think he does, mate.
Oh, does he?
Think he does, mate. Yeah.
I didn't think he played anymore on the IPA.
No, I genuinely think he does play on the IPA.
Well, he's tried to cannon that out, Danny. But I thought he could have held that.
No, I think he were a little bit too thin. Both players won.
I know they won the amateur titles last year, but I don't think he's on anymore. I didn't think he was.
No.
Maybe I'm wrong.
Yeah, both players still play on it. Jack and Lee both won an IPA amateur event last year. This year, well, last event actually, Lee, he didn't have a lucky week. I don't mean to sound horrible up to the people in the chat. Someone's asked at UK Tour. No, Greg, it's not. It's the IPA Tour, the Black Ball Rules Tour. But the people in chat saying that he's had a lucky weekend. You can't have a lucky weekend beating the likes of the players that he's been beating.
I mean, he sent us through a bit of a bio of himself so we could like talk about him during the match, and he sent us through his world championship campaign in what, 2011?
Yeah.
And he's beating the likes of Rob Warne,
Rob Chilton, Mark Farnsworth,
all in the same tournament.
He's beat
any man that can do that. He's capable of beating anyone.
In fact, Mark, I've still got a text on my phone, and I'll get this up, and I'll, you know, we're sounding quite pro.
That's right. Jack is on the UK Tour because he played Tom Cousins in the final.
No, Jack played Tom Cousins in the final of like a play.
No, definitely. I remember it.
Mark, it were a play event. Asbo has a chance here. If I'm wrong about obviously Jack being on the IPA Tour, obviously I apologise.
Mm-hmm. Pepper too. Yeah, it looks like he has played on the IPA as well. Just had a quick look on the website and he's on the IPA Tour website.
Right, so people who are saying that Lee can't beat Jack, and I'll just reel these off. April 2012, UK amateur champion on the IPA Tour. World Championships 2011, obviously, at World Rules. His first attempt in the Worlds, he beat Craig Lake in 7-4. Rob Warne 7-0, by the way, which is an awesome result. Rob Chilton 8-3, which is an even better result. And Mark Farnsworth 8-6, getting to the final. To the quarterfinals. To name just a few of the 17 matches that he won to get to that point.
Yeah.
Now that tells me, Mark, that this lad can play.
He's an animal. Yeah.
When he gets going, 1 second.
Yeah, fantastic shot from Lee there. Big pressure on that, obviously, 9-2. Needs to get as many frames on the board as he can. Just needs to take his time on this one, just make sure he gets the right nudge he needs. He's got it, so he's going to screw back and play the black into the bottom left. Well, he's stunned over to the left hand side, so played it well, so this will be 9-3 now. Lee needs to see if he can get a foothold in this match.
That were a lovely shot on the last red there.
Oh,
is that a miss from Jack Mark?
Yeah, he's tried to power it in to try free the other ball up at the bottom of the table, and it's
sorry mate, I'm gonna have to get a bit closer. I can't hear you.
He's tried to play hard to free up so the other balls as well, and he's rattled it in the jaws in the middle. So it's still open table for Lee.
All right then.
Tell you what, Danny, we must be doing something right. We've attracted a few champions tonight.
Champions?
We've got Mr. Hill, Mr. Chilton, oh, Mr. Mellon.
Oh, are they all in?
They're all here.
Oh, hello. I might be out getting some games then. Yes, we're doing something right here, Mark. Must be the personalities we've got.
Must be that. Has Chilts brought the yellow pages to stand on so he can see? Someone says in the chat.
Maybe.
No comment.
He'll have to stand at front if he has, because if he hasn't brought 10 yellow pages, then he's not going to see table, is he?
Oh, dear. Oh, poor lad, get some stick.
Do you reckon we can get Melon in for a cheeky stint on commentary?
Nah.
I don't either.
He's out for one thing and one thing only.
Beer.
To get drunk. Lee with decent chance here now. Needs a decent angle on this. Next ball. Wow.
He's nailed that one.
Oh, I didn't see that shot, to be fair, but yeah, he's played it really well.
Yeah, he's screwed back off the cush. He needs to play this with a fair bit of top right-hand side.
Do them two go, Danny, do you think? Or is he's going to have to cannon those out, isn't he?
One of them top one possibly goes in middle, Mark.
Yeah, I think it does. Do you reckon he sort of like spins it and gets on this, or do you reckon he cannons them out?
Yeah, pretty much.
Which? Spin it and gets on it and don't hit it.
He's not hit it at all, has he?
He's tried spinning and getting on it, hasn't he? He's just tried spinning it in and landing on it.
It's not worked, has it?
Should just be a little safety here, just glance off the edge, come back in between the two yellows.
Just like that?
Yep, just like that.
That'll do him.
We got Mr. We had some static then. Wow.
I would half expecting Lee Clough to be here tonight, Mark, with Lee. I know he's very, very good friends with him. Partners.
Yeah.
I would half expecting that.
Yeah, me too. We've got Mr. Residi in the chat. Well done on your victory today, pal.
Yeah.
Good atmosphere well that game. Very good atmosphere.
It was.
Especially when all the guys from this game started to filter in towards the end.
I'll be honest, Mark. Me and you both said Stefan to win. I said, oh.
No, we said Ben.
What a shot that is. What a shot that is.
Yeah, good shot. Wow.
I said I fancied Ben Clayton. I thought Steph might just make too many mistakes for him.
To be honest with you, I said to Stefan before the match, my exact words, and he'll confirm this, was you will win 4, 5, 6, 7 frames on the bounce. It just depends when that happens. And what did he do?
Luckily, did it end.
He won the last 5 on the bounce.
Exactly. Fair play. Well done, kid. Well done. I'm absolutely made up for you, mate. It's not the worst shot, Mark, but he can definitely clear these up. Can Jack?
He can definitely pot the one on the right hand side of the table. I'm not sure whether he can pot the one next to the black. He's looking at that one.
Yeah, I think he can.
Where's the middle? No.
So does the middle one of the three at the bottom go? That is the big question here, Mark. Because if it does, frame over. Jack's coming around to have a look.
No, to be honest with you, Stefan, I wouldn't say skeptics, but you know, I did think Ben probably had the edge, and like you say, you've proved us all wrong, and congratulations.
I'll be honest, I genuinely said if Stefan brings his best game, and I said it on the chat for the first match, if Stefan brings his best game, then Stefan's going to be extremely difficult to beat. And I'm glad he did. He didn't bring his A game all game, but neither did Ben. And as with all money games, Mark, the best player won on the day. So well done, Steph, lad. Nice Nah, there's three decent players stood in a line there, Mark.
In no particular order.
In no particular order. You've got Mellon, Hill, Chilton. Which one of them's best?
Depends what you mean at. Depends what you mean at.
At this game?
Hill.
Hill? I'll go Mellon.
Hill.
Hill all round. Mellon, because he's mental.
Mellon's just talent.
Yeah, supreme. Supreme talent.
Unbelievable.
Oh, cracking shot.
Yeah, great shot from Asbel.
That shot deserves
much,
him to
much
not
harder
lose.
Than it looked.
Yeah, it deserves him to knock these next two in.
Well,
yeah, Mellon for sure, Hill for Doe.
There's absolutely no argument. They're both in the top five ever to have played the game.
For me, Mark, the top, and I know how good Gareth Potts is, but the top three is Hill, Appleton, Mellon.
You've got to include Gareth Potts in that. You have. There's an elite five.
Oh, what a great shot that is.
Yeah, good shot from Lee. There's an elite five.
Yeah,
there
is. Yeah.
It's Mellon, Hill, Appleton.
Well, would you go Selby or would you go?
No,
no.
Brewer, Potts.
Brewer.
Selby and Han have won one thing. They haven't won the amount of tournaments that the rest of the other guys have. They might be better players, but if they don't play, how can you call them great?
True. Mark Selby is.
There's no way you can't say Brewer's not in the top 10 in the play, ever played the game because he won everything for 10 years.
What has he won? Has he won 13 world titles?
He won everything for 10 years, albeit at EPA rules.
But we're not on about rules, are we?
No, we're not on about rules. But he is top five ever to have played the game. Whether that's EPA or whatever.
He's got a shot on it, Mark. That's all he can ask for. Ross McInnes.
Top five ever?
No, not top five ever. No chance.
No. That's your top. That's
top
your elite
five. Top five Scottish,
five.
Maybe.
That's your elite five.
Yeah, the elite five.
Probably Mark Lund just sneaks out of top five. we're not talking about for cash. We're talking about best
cracking.
Players.
Cracking shot. No, we're not talking about cash, Mark.
No, we're just talking about simply best players.
Yeah. Mark Farnsworth, if you're talking about Mark Farnsworth for cash...
I'd agree with you.
But you've then got to talk about Tom Cousins, haven't you? Surely. And I know Tom's beaten once, but then you've got to say, right then, Ronan McCarthy's got to be right up there, and then Rob Chilton's got to be... Again, he smashed Tom Cousins, and Tom Cousins... smash Farnsworth. So how do you, Simon Ward's not in the, yeah. Simon Ward's a great player. Simon Ward's a great amateur. Simon Ward's a cracking player. I will not dispute how good Simon Ward is.
What you've won and necessarily isn't necessarily what makes you elite.
No,
like, look at Ronnie. He hasn't won as much as Endre, but he's still better than him.
Stephen
no matter
Endre,
which way you look at it.
Stephen Endre, on titles, is the best snooker player ever.
Yeah,
he
but
isn't.
He's not.
Ronnie is.
Yeah, exactly.
Without a doubt. But if you look at titles, Stephen Endre,
to be fair, this guy here saying you can name 25 that can beat each other. Yeah, anyone can beat each other. That's just the nature of the game. But they are the elite five, in my opinion.
Yeah, of course they are, mate. Of course they are, mate. And I totally agree with that. It's... Yeah, we'll host that, no problem. We'll stream it as well, you know. We're nice guys like that. Is this Jack at the table? I can't quite see, Mark. Yeah, it is. Oh.
What would you rather win, commentators, Tony or Cash?
Cash.
Tony. Because Tony comes with cash. Nah. Tony comes with more cash than Cash Game. Could you play for 10 grand, you might only have a grand on yourself. You win a tourney, that's you true. Win 10 grand, you win 10 grand.
True.
A tourney's harder to win.
True.
Because you have to beat more people. Therefore, it's more prolific. You get more of a buzz from it because you have a title, not just saying, I beat that guy.
You get a bigger reputation for cash, to be fair. For tourneys.
Honestly, I'd say tourneys. Cash games are a big part of it, like, obviously, but...
It really depends on the sort of player you are.
Another monster finish from Jack. Is this another Brett Dish, Dan?
Yes, it is.
No, it can't be. Because Jack broke frame one. So this is frame.
Good point. Someone's asking in the chat. Is Chilton going to still play in Alley? Well, there's your answer, probably. Did we stream the World 8 Ball Championships? No, we did not. We are not Sky Sports. Sky Sports
if they want
filmed
us, they know where we are.
Yeah, Sky Sports filmed it. They'll put it on maybe October time.
Cash players are better. I don't agree with that.
No, what it is...
At the end of the day, do you get remembered? When you're dead, do you get remembered for the most money matches you've won?
No, you do not.
You get remembered for the world titles.
For being absolute multiple world championship winner. He won't get remembered for winning loads of seniors tours.
No, he won't.
Or beating... I don't know if he's played for money. He probably hasn't. He doesn't need to, let's be honest. He probably won't need to. But he won't get remembered for playing someone for $2,000.
Yeah, but he's known for cash, but he's alive.
Yeah, when but he's also known for being a fantastic player.
He's obviously done well in tournaments as well. He's an all-round player. There's a difference between just a cash player.
Who else would daft enough to play pots? No one really. Ollie Bale, in my opinion, daft.
No, yeah, he's daft. He'll admit he's daft.
He's not going to beat Gareth Potts for cash. But let's get back to this game, Mark. 10-4 to Jack, and if I'm honest, mate, you know, I've called Lee. I called it earlier. The way Jack's playing, Mark,
it's tough to see a way.
Lee ain't winning this for me, anyway. At this moment in time, it's very, very tough to see. I'm trying to remain as impartial as possible here, but it's tough to do when Jack's literally not missing a ball, isn't it?
Yeah, it's tough to see from here, mate. It's tough to see Jack crumbling.
Jack's absolutely Jack's showing no nerves whatsoever.
Or Lee knocking on to the next gear. I do believe Lee still has another gear. Lee definitely has another gear, but...
Oh, Lee has two or three.
Jack's
showing no nerves.
And that's another break dish, Dan.
Lee's making every finish look tough, don't you agree? Every finish... I honestly think Lee's making the finishes he's getting look a lot tougher than Jack is, and Jack just looks confident, Mark.
If Jack wins, would he play Ward? We'll ask him after the game.
I will definitely ask him. I'm probably going to say no. I'm going to say no, Mark. Although,
to be fair,
on this
mate,
performance...
To be fair, mate, if he beats Ward, who else is he going to play?
There's no one.
He has to then step up to the likes of Tom and Ronan and those kind of players. And He doesn't want to do that because the natural progression is to earn as much money as you can up to that point.
And that's the nature of cash games, Mark. You've got to play the players who want to play you at the time, who you know you can beat.
Yeah, you have, yeah.
You know, there's absolutely no point you taking... Like, Jack is, you know, an extremely, extremely talented player. But let's be honest, let's say for Jack, there's no point Jack taking on someone like Tom Cousins so early and then beating him, and then that's his cash game's ruined for the next 10 years, isn't it?
Exactly, yeah. That's my point. That's why Wad didn't want to step up to Ronan straight away. That's why he played the likes of like Mark White and that beforehand.
Yeah.
No offense to those guys, but they're obviously not as good for as prolific as well known for cash as he is.
I have to fucking put my neck on line and say I hold my hat off. I take my hat off to Ian Alley if he's going to play Rob Chilton at Black Ball Rules. I mean, I know Ian loves Black Ball Rules. He really does. Rob has only played him for the 2 years. But
what played Mark White? What played Mark White home and away for 10 grand?
Battered him, didn't he?
I'm not saying he's not awesome. I'm just saying that he's not as well known as Ronan. Oh, so yeah. Wad beating Mark White is not going to mean anything to the next guy. Wad beating Ronan is going to kill his action altogether.
Wad nearly beating Ronan is going to mean a lot, let's be honest.
I know Mark White's awesome. I've played him. Beat him. One frame.
It just doesn't look like missing.
No. Sick.
He's got to get right behind this one though, Mark.
Ainsley Daniels is the man, isn't he? That's all.
Ainsley is a machine.
Yeah.
Whoever he is.
Yeah,
I've
never
machine.
Heard of him, but you know, must be good.
Nah. I said he's got to get right behind it, Mark. What's he done?
There's only one Jack Wynn.
Get right behind it. Mark White, did he beat Wad?
He beat Wad, yeah.
Oh, did he? Fair play to him.
But then Wad beat him in the return game.
Right. Someone give me Mark White's number. If he beat Wad, I'll get that kid again.
Good shot from Jack now.
How's Jack's body language, Mark? You can see my cat.
He's the first thing I did was look up at him, actually, to be fair. He's examining. He huffed a little bit. He's getting he's double
he's
checking.
He's looking at it, so
he's looking as though he's gonna play this. He's just he can pot this. He's just saying to his pre-shot routine, he can make this.
This goes for me. All I'll ask, Mark, is if Ainsley Daniels calls himself a pool player and he doesn't know who Quinton Han is, he probably could do with not being a pool player anymore. Jesus H. Christ.
You don't even hit the brake hard and the balls just go everywhere.
Earlier on, they were hitting the brake so hard and nothing was going
on. I'm
going
to put this one out there, Danny. You play the yellow that's not the one over the middle. You play the one next to it and screw into the middle one. Yeah,
like that.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. Oh, he's been unlucky there.
Bit unfortunate there. However, he can play the one that he's closest to now and screw into the one that's tied on. Yeah, the Jack's break is massive. I'll agree with Eric Dock.
It's huge. We said though, like at this standard, the break is a difference.
Massive, mate.
Especially at black ball rolls.
He's not even looking to break this out. He's,
it can drop on it. It goes in the middle. Oh, he's been unlucky.
Ooh.
He can play safe though, yeah?
Yeah, he'll go behind the two yellows here, won't he?
Yeah, definitely. Play thin off this, bit of left-hand side, behind these two yellows. All Jack wants to do now is keep Lee in the seat for as long as he can. He's not going to go for the double here. Sure he's not.
Well, hang on. Yep. Oh, he's left one. He's left at least a hit on one, Mark.
You just want to keep Lee from winning frames. If, as long as you stop Lee from winning frames, You're just gonna get to the line, whether that's 21-10 or 21-20.
Yeah, it doesn't 25. Matter. Doesn't the score in a money game doesn't matter?
Absolutely irrelevant as long as you get over the line.
I said this earlier, Matt, but I genuinely do hope Lee hits a gear, and I hope that this game becomes.
By the way,
what a shot!
Fantastic shot.
I hope this game becomes a spectacle that it really should be and it deserves to be.
Yeah.
And I just 100% you know,
agree.
And for the people who in the chat who might have money on Lee or Jack, you know, to me or Mark, it really doesn't matter who wins this game. We want to see the best game possible, and we want all the fans to see the best game possible, obviously. the people who've got money on want to see the most one-sided game.
There you go. That's what Jack's going to play. Isn't
he? One of them two.
If he hits that first one, then fair enough.
Played but your second one.
If he goes round the back. He had a good chance of getting it safe then.
That's not a fluke.
Nah, his odds were good, but he still played a great shot.
That's not a fluke at all.
Unbelievable.
That's two of them, Mark, that he's been in a bit of trouble and he's got out of it and got Lee back in the snooker.
Lee's sat there thinking, what am I going to do? What am I going to do with me two? Or what am I going to do after this? Not thinking, how am I going to get out of this snooker? I mean, after I've just left it, laid him in a big snooker. Yeah, that's an unbelievable shot from Jack. Because there's now nothing Lee can do.
It's outrageous.
I mean, Lee's probably going to go two rails and try to get safe on this one, but he can't get it safe.
The absolute only way Lee can get this safe. He's played that really well, Mark.
Yeah, I mean,
has he left a double one?
He has. This is why I said he couldn't really get it safe. He was struggling to get that perfect, so he didn't leave anything. He's missed.
It's dropped.
Wow. How has that gone in?
Wow.
How has that
wow,
gone
wow,
in?
Wow, 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 wow.
That shouldn't go in. And this is obviously our table, Danny, and that shouldn't go in.
That shouldn't go in, mate. The cue ball control though, from Jack is...
I tell you what, he's not great on this, is he?
No.
He's wrong side.
I don't think he'd be too bothered about putting the black.
Yeah, it looks a lot easier on the overhead, on the straight in.
Yes.
Yeah, 13-4. And I'm going to the loop.
13-4, and you can hear Jack's fans. Jack's having a quick break. Say this again, simply for the spectacle. I hope Lee makes it close. I favour no player because I am as impartial as they get. But I want it to be a very good game for the viewers. I don't want it to be a one-sided procession. Andy, that's probably me just having a few beers. How many world titles did Keith win? You can maybe enlighten me, mate, to be fair. I don't know anything about the EPA world titles. He won none. He won the EPAs, though. You're saying that he won none. He won world titles at EPA rules, surely. Andy, you're saying that it wasn't a world championships. It does count as a world title, though, to Keith. I'm not arguing with you. I totally agree that EPA rules. I mean, if you play EPA rules and you win a world title, you shouldn't be classed as a world title. But Andy, I totally agree where you're coming from. It might not have been called the World Championships, but
I didn't know about the World Championship thing. I didn't know about Brewer's World Championship.
Andy will probably know more than I do because he's.
But I think honestly, I think you've still got to put Keith in the top because he dominated the EPA rules for so long, and there's no one that can deny that.
To be fair, Andy made a very good shout saying Jason Twist.
Yeah, Jason Twist has been a consistent player, but
Jason Twist, cracking player. And I, you know, I'm not arguing with anyone's opinion, Mark.
No, that's at the end of the day, it's an opinion, isn't it?
Of course it is. I say Mick, Daz, Mellin, Potts, and one other, and there's absolutely no getting away from that fact. For me, there's nothing.
Larkin won 17-16 from 17-11 down. He's done well there, hasn't he?
Larkin last night, yeah, against Seb Webb.
He won 17-16 from 17-11
down. Oh,
yeah, down.
He won 18-17, I'll have you know.
Steve Davis is in top five. When's your flight back to Earth?
At the end of the day, everyone's got their own opinions, Mark, on Paul and on the players and all that. Oh, that's a lovely shot.
Interested to see people's opinions on it, but
of course it's interesting. Everyone's opinions are obviously going to differ.
Yeah, of course they are.
My opinion is simply we've got three of the world's top five best ever players here now. Mellin.
Mick. Two.
Chilton, I mean,
Chilton's in it. Chilton's got a shout.
Chilton's got a shout. Yeah, maybe not top five, but you know, Chris.
Lee's totally took his eye off that.
Thank you.
Jack probably just going to be trying to sneak in behind this yellow on the bottom rail here. Far from easy shot. That is left a pretty decent chance here now. I think he's actually tried to screw into that red to try free it up a little bit, but it's worked out okay. Can just screw back for that now. Decent finish from Lee in the end. Mistake from Jack's obviously let him in. 13-5. Jack's just absolutely demolishes the break every single time. So it's relentless. Relentless is the only word for it. Unbelievable. Anywhere over at right hand side of the table, he's got him to either bottom left or middle left, as long as he doesn't catch the near knuckle of the middle. Well, even if you land there, you've got it into the bottom right. Apologises to Lee. Yeah, it's another break dish from Jack. You can see Jack absolutely dominating the break. Six break runs to Lee's one. Come on, Jack. Doesn't help Lee's cause when he can't make a ball off the break. Tried to free that red up at the top right there, but not quite. I think he's just probably just play it out now.
Oh my god.
Great shot from Lee. Now I think we'll see him play the ball in the middle. We're into the yellow at the top left hand of your screen. Obviously he can pop the red over the corner. Stubbs is then still going to have the issue with yellow on the right hand side of the table where the red is, but with any luck that yellow that he, well, he's not even playing that shot. Wow, can't believe it. Looks to be covering the right hand side pocket. He's played it well, but Jack's going to pop the I think Jack here is just going to pop the ball over the right, over the left hand corner bag and run into that yellow over the right hand corner bag. Obviously he's just played the skill shot. Yeah, for me, Lee played the wrong shot there. Trying to get that ball over the right hand corner bag. Should have just played the skill shot. Pop the one in the middle. Make the red over the corner bag. Where's the cue ball? Where's the cue ball? Ooh. I think someone just made a bit of a noise while he were down his shot there. So get us up and start again. Fair play.
Back with you now, Mark.
I just don't know what Lee can do.
No.
I mean, he's played the wrong shot in the last frame for me, and Jack's punished him for it.
I wasn't watching, obviously, but if I'm honest, Bullock won't be far wrong in the chat room. 13 grand pot on Lee won't get to double figures at this rate. It's a fair comment.
Well, to be fair, at this rate, 15-5, it'd be 30-10, wouldn't it? And he only needs to get to 25.
Oh my god. He just smacked that double in.
If he gets these, Danny, this is break dish number 7. They've only played 20 frames. They've only played 20 frames, and this would be break dish number 7.
That's 33%.
That's 33% misses.
30% of. It's more because.
That's 70%, mate. He only breaks half of them.
Yeah, no, sorry, I meant of the total frames. But yeah, you're right, yeah. Jesus. But that's not to say Jack's broke dish. Oh, yeah, it is.
If he's made 7 out of 10 breaks, he's at 70%, mate.
Yeah,
that is ridiculous.
It's not bad. Well, Rob Chilton's here watching him. He might even be backing him, Mark, so he probably won't fancy playing him at this rate, will he?
I'll tell you what, mate, he's gone a hard way about this.
Yeah. If I'm honest, mate, I fancy him getting him, simple as that.
I'm going to play this for screwing right hand side. Spin it down.
No,
I don't
want to
go behind the yellow.
Big chance for Lee now.
Jack calls
a
total.
Chance for Lee.
Jack's just going to whack this. Top bag.
Did he hit the red?
He hit the red, yeah.
The red.
Yeah, we all know that Mick's got a bet and Melin and blah, 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 blah. They're off out town. They're off out back Vegas. Tell you what, has he even left this?
No, he hasn't left that, Mark. I can see that from the stream.
I can see the right-hand side of it, though.
I'm going to say...
That brings the swerve into play.
Yeah, the swerve coming into play, though, Mark. The speed he's going to have to play, it means he's going away from the black. Nah, he's going in behind it to try and kick it in, which...
He don't go. The kicking doesn't go.
No.
He must be rolling behind
it. Going.
Is it too hard? Oh, right. So it's a nothing shot.
Yeah. He must have obviously not been able to see it, Mark.
Yeah, you know, you're right, actually. Yeah.
I'll tell you something. If a player like Lee isn't getting these, then, again, in the most respectful way it can possibly sound, he wants to be evaluating his money match career.
Yep.
I've got a hell of a lot of time for Lee. He's been excellent with me for the last sort of 2 months, 3 months since this game's been announced. It's been great. But it really, really needs to be getting these. Because 15-5 is some scoreline, Mark, in a money match.
Thank you.
Beautiful shot. Beautiful shot. Lovely use of side. Do you know, it sounds daft, but it's actually good to see Lee taking out a confidence building finish.
Yeah, you're right.
How's this going? Dry. Too many dry breaks from Lee Mark. He'll admit that himself.
Yeah, mate. I mean, Jack's break's just been out of this world so far.
It has, mate.
I mean, Lee had a few chances early doors, but he didn't take them.
He did. He missed
5-0.
He missed a couple of balls in the first three frames. I know Jack broke dish one of them, but he missed a couple of balls in the first three frames, which for Lee weren't tough balls, were they? And Lee will know you cannot afford to do that against someone like Jack. That's just cue ball control at his finest, Mark.
It makes it look so easy, doesn't
it? It really does.
And that's what the best players do. And if depending on what kind of path he wants to take, he could be a world champion.
Yeah, and I genuinely believe that. As even playing on the IPA tour, I mean, and you know, at these rules with the likes of Gareth, Adam, I genuinely believe Jack could be as good as he wanted to be. If he went on the UK tour, you know, which I'm not condoning, man.
It's not the right thing to do. No matter if you'd win every single event, it's still not the right thing to do.
I have no comment. But I genuinely believe, even on the IPA tour, Mark, that playing like this, Jack can beat anyone. Because let's be honest, if you don't miss, how are you going to get beat? You cannot get beat if you don't miss, can you?
No, at the end of the day, not very often, no.
There's not a prayer you can get beat if you don't miss.
Not often. 99% of the time you'll win.
Jesus. Honestly, he will be playing like this. I mean, you know, what's he done now? It's 6 break and runs in 16 frames. Right.
22. He's had 11 breaks and ran 6.
So in the frames he's won, he's about 40% break dish in the frames he's won.
Of the frames he's won.
Overall frames, 7 break dishes in 22. It's just under 30%. Now, that's not the worst standard.
No. I mean, he's broke dished. Oh.
Now,
he's broke dished 6 out of 11 breaks. Six out of 12 breaks now.
So it's 50%.
50%. It's good in anyone's book.
So it's I don't care who you are, Mark. That's impressive. Now Lee's got a big chance here on yellows.
It's all about
to be honest,
black.
The best thing you can do is probably free the black up here.
Free the black up first shot.
But do you know something, Mark? When you're 16-6 down in a money match for nearly £13,500, taking these out with one shot doesn't quite seem so simple, does it?
No, mate.
Not as simple as when you're in practice anyway.
Someone's just said he's 16-6 down. It's not exactly a great standard. Well, that doesn't really reflect the standard whatsoever. The standard is that Jack's excelled. Even if it were 22-0 right now, Jack could have still buzzed.
Jack's. Ah, oh, there's a rule I didn't know, Mark.
Yeah, the first shot's always always a free ball.
Always free. Yep. Yeah. I didn't know that. I thought, as with the rules, if the first ball you pop is the ball you're on.
Nope.
First legal ball. No. That's fair enough. I fully expect Jack Lee to get these now. I'll tell you something, Mark. No, you know, despite
everyone in the chat takes everything we say out of context.
Yeah.
How can you say that Jack hasn't excelled? He's broke dish 50%. Whether that's his standard or not, that's still excelling in a money match.
Someone's talking about Warren Hodgson on the chat. I'd just like to say Warren Hodgson was due to play Rob Wilson, actually. But unfortunately, Warren did confirm he's unable to actually play weekends due to his job, which obviously was unfortunate. I were looking forward to that. Lot aside on that. Good shot. And 16-7.
Want to see Lee win the next few now.
Yeah, so do I, Mark. And
get a foothold in the match.
I want to see him win the next few, simply because I want him to make a game of it. I could do with some life in that pint, though, I'll tell you that.
Beautiful.
As Terry Tibbs would say, very nice.
Very nice indeed.
As a bar. Camper van. Talk to me. I'm not joking.
Yes! That's both fine that makes the ball off the break.
What reds is he looking at here? I think that's Dan Eaton in the chat, Mark. Dan Eaton Lees, who said you have to play well to win money matches, but it's how you get through the bad patches which is key. I actually couldn't agree more. If you can get through a bad patch only losing 50% of your frames when you're not playing well, you've got to put yourself in massive contention for that money match.
Average frame time on is 6 minutes 22 seconds.
People are talking about Jack and take it Lee got the spider he was after.
Yes.
259 viewers, Mark. We're doing all right, lad. One good shot from Lee, it's frame over. Beautiful, beautiful stuff. So, this, Mark, is looking like 16-8. If I can just drop this in the middle.
Lee's strung a few frames together here.
Yeah, and, you know, we both said, again, and I keep mentioning this, as impartially as possible, Mark. We wanted him to do this just to make a game of it. You know, absolutely fair play to Jack, and he's been fantastic, he really has. He's literally not missed a ball. But let's be honest, in a money match, unless you're actually backing one of the players, you don't want to see... Wow, that's not something I expected, I'll be honest.
Yeah, Jesus. Damien Cooper, some guy comes up to me and he goes, they want a spider. I went, we'll go look for one then. What do you want to do? Magic one out of my ass. You know, does he think I just keep a random stash of spider rest just by my side?
Sorry, Mark, I didn't hear none of that. I was still absolutely perplexed that Lee's missed that. I honestly can't believe it, mate. That's crazy. Well then. Is that the first ball Jack's missed for about 9 frames?
It's one of the first he's missed all night.
Yeah, Damien Cooper's got it right in the chat. Jack is actually human.
Nah, I need evidence. One ball in evidence. Jack's playing for a rematch, obviously. No, I'm only joking.
Yeah, rematch here, yeah?
Yeah, of course.
I'm genuinely surprised. I mean,
the players are just going to go on a quick timeout, so we'll leave you with that.
I'll go do the table.
Stop! Oh, yes. Well, you know, I think fucking Lee Hansen's got a chance here. I think Jack Whelan's in front, but you never know. Who can win? I think Lee Asbow, Anderson from Blackpool.
Thank you.
Right, we're back in, and surprise, surprise, Jack pulls out another monster break. Got a decent chance for the finish on yellows. Played that well. Now, if he knocks this one in up the rail, he's guaranteed to be on the ball to the right middle. Then the ball to the left middle. And then a good night, BNS 17-8. And another break dish for Jack if this ball goes in. And stayed up. Just caught the rail. Just caught the rail before it got to the pocket. He's going to need to try to play the skill shot over that for that yellow at the top left. I'm not sure if he's got enough angle to do it right now. Off this red, he's queuing up. I think he does. Well, he's played to pot the red, but the yellow. Sorry, but that's just as good. If he can come sort of on that line, anywhere there, he can then play the red into the bottom right hand corner as we look. Line's not bad. Perfect line. So I'll just drop this now. It was like Hawkeye with that. Drop this in. Maybe even cannon into the yellow to the right if he can. If he's got enough angle for that. That'll be the best shot. If it's possible. Well, he's played it, but has he got it? Is he on this red? Nope, the answer is no.
Back with you, Mark. Sorry about that. We're just having a quick chat with Chris Mellin, saying he'll play someone if they fancy it. Yeah.
Lee had a fairly simple pot there, Danny, just to knock that yellow out of the way and be on the red into the bottom right corner, and he's ended up there.
I take it he's not played it the best then.
He had a red over the middle and the yellow next to it, and he's knocked the yellow to there and the white there.
So instead of like stunning into it,
he's topped it and hit the back side of it.
There's no value in, for me, topping into that. You've got to stun it every time, every day of the week. You've got to stun that. You know. After Lee bringing a few frames back, he's handing a frame there to Jack and Ian.
And that's now 17-8, and Jack's break next, yeah. I think.
I'll agree with Bullock in the chat room there. Lee's played a fair few Poor shot tonight.
It's not Dax Break. It's I'm Leeds Break sure next one.
He'll agree, Mark. He'll know that he's not played his best. No, nowhere near. Jack probably hasn't played his best, but he's played something like, hasn't he?
No, well, yeah, I mean, he's obviously played. He's obviously played good. Otherwise, he wouldn't be 17-8 up against anyone if he hadn't played well.
Break hasn't worked tonight at all.
What a great shot that is from Jack Whelan. 18-8 is going to be at this spot.
Thank you.
18-9, Mark.
I know, mate. I know, it feels like we've lost a little bit of interest here, but there's not been a great deal to commentate on, to be fair.
Yeah, it's...
it's one of them.
I'm a little bit gutted because it's been a bit of a procession. Neither of us wanted that. Certainly didn't expect that. Someone says commentators last seen at bar licking Melin's crack. I think that will be commentator last seen at bar speaking to Melin and Melin telling him that he would like a money game. Yeah.
He's just a keyboard warrior like rest of them on chat.
Meh, warrior. That means he's obviously here. Or he just heard me say I was speaking to Melin.
Well, if he's here, we'll see if it's a keyboard warrior or not, won't we?
Gay! I agree with Pupsky. He needs three games to everyone of Jack's. Very tough ask. However,
when Jack's doing that, he's got a chance.
Throw one in, and these, well, neither set look bad here, Mark.
Huh?
Neither set look bad here, do they?
Neither set, no. Both look good. His head's gone.
As most fans are saying, his head's gone.
Melin get drinks. Did Melin get drinks in? Are you well, Pupsky?
No, he did not.
Of course he didn't.
The atmosphere, Mark, is
electric.
Brilliant, it's brilliant here. Do you think he'll go yellows or reds here?
I think he'll go reds.
I think there's a lot more work to do with a cue ball if he goes yellows.
Exactly, that's
he's
why
only got
he'll
one
go
hard
red.
Shot, one hard ball on reds. If he knocks this in and doesn't move that red too much, he don't want to get him behind that though.
The red goes in the right hand corner.
He's all right there. Well, quick check.
Yeah, he's fine.
I'm just looking at that last comment in chat there. I won't repeat it because that's not very nice.
To be honest with you, I feel there's been a lot of disrespect towards Lee in the chat. I think there's been a lot of disrespect towards Lee in the chat.
Yeah, a lot of negativity and a lot of disrespect. A lot of people don't understand how good Lee really is. He's obviously not playing that, Mark. He's not playing that standard that he can get to.
No, of course he isn't. But I still think he deserves some respect.
He deserves some credit for at least for even turning up and playing for this money against someone like Jack Whelan. He deserves the credit for me.
Then people in chat can give me as much stick as they want, but that's true.
Yeah, they won't hear any disrespect off us. No danger. And I fancy Lee for these, mate. If he just sort of stuns this in, pulls it back 3 inches, 4 inches.
Yeah, definitely, mate. There's a lot of people stumbling over.
There's a lot of people falling over the floor, isn't there?
No, there's a lot of people stumbling because they're drunk.
One good shot here, Mark, and this is 18-10, and I know it's still not exactly close, but Lee's back sort of within a chance.
Yeah, great
lovely shot.
Lovely shot.
Joe Hood, you're doing my head in. at the moment, yes, it does look like there's only one winner, Mark.
Yeah, well, there is only one winner, Danny, but that is absolutely not the point. Lee still doesn't deserve to be disrespected by the people in the chat when they don't have the balls to come and do it themselves.
He deserves a lot of respect, in my eyes. And he got that before the game even started.
Yes, next, we can barge over from the chat, and I'm seriously contemplating it right now.
We can bar Joe Hood from chat. But we don't want to really bar him. But all we want is... But to be honest, we like the banter. We like a lot of banter, Mark. But it is a lot of disrespect. I'm not sure what bullet means, why we're bitter. We actually favour no player.
Yeah, we don't back anyone.
I can guarantee you, we both have not backed Lee.
It's just the point is, we don't get players to come onto our stream and then just sit by while people slag them off on the stream.
No way.
On the chat, it's just bang out of line.
And the one thing we certainly don't do is get players to come onto our stream and back them.
No, we don't, because that's...
I've just been telling someone
that takes all credibility out of it.
The only three players I would back, apart from myself, Mark, is you, Sam Hurst and Liam Waterworth, because you're all my close friends. It's as simple as that. However,
you've been biased to Lee all night. We've been biased to Lee all night, apparently.
Alright, okay. Is that biased or biased? I'm not.
Yeah, he's with the name like you've big.
Not big Jack up. Jack's been absolutely phenomenal.
Right, yeah, okay. Yeah, just like that bullock clearly lives on another planet. So
he's obviously a fan of Jack, and I respect his opinion, but I don't see how we've.
There we go. John Attridge getting his first show in the match here.
Dry break in the chat has absolutely nailed it. We wanted a close match for the viewers, not for us. Not for the... You know, we wanted a massive, massive spectacle for the fans here. I'm absolutely expected one, and... blah. If we've been biased against Jack... And I apologise, but I'm pretty sure when Jack watches this back, he will realise that we haven't actually. Jack has been sensational. He's missed what, four balls, Mark? If that.
We are very biased.
Very biased.
Well, that means we've got two asses.
Oh, each.
Each? Oh, two asses each.
I like that.
Biased. Jack, this another break dish, Dan.
When a finish has been on, mate, Jack hasn't looked like missing it, has he?
No, we can't big Jack up because we're favouring Lee, aren't we? Oh, according to these in the chat.
Can't do this.
Do you know what I mean?
Do you know what? Bollocks to them in the chat. Jack hasn't missed the ball.
Mate, none of them are here. We don't care about any of them in the chat because none of them are here. None of them. Are man enough to voice their opinions in person.
Damien Cooper. Fair play. Don't watch if you don't like it. Like, as balls break. It's a big one, is that? But. Yeah, I fancy these reds, Matt. No problem, thank you. Cheers. I never take it too serious, don't worry. I love the banter. Mark doesn't.
I've just banned Blakey DCFC, whoever he is. Say just because I can.
Which you can?
Yep. Ta-da.
No, I love the banter meet, to be fair. I'm the biggest banter merchant going. I want respect for both players, that's all it is, mate. And
I know that's not Joey, he just ripped some I didn't like, so I'd delete it.
They both deserve a hell of a lot of respect, even for turning up, Matt, to play for this money. And the performance Jack's put in.
This is my point, though, Danny. It's not great to have the people in the chat who never achieved anything that Lee's achieved, never got the balls to do what Lee's done, and they're slagging him off. It's just
totally
not
agree.
Right.
I'll never achieve what Lee's achieved. But I'll tell you something.
They're not slagging Jack off, are they?
No.
Because he's winning.
I'd have the balls to play for this sort of money. If I thought it were a fair game, I'd have the balls to play for it. But yeah, these guys who are slating Lee probably won't. The only reason I'm sort of on Lee's side is because I want him to make a game of it. It's as simple as that. I have no favourites. I have no money on the game, so the outcome is irrelevant. Pupski says we take things too serious. Pupski's dead right, innit? Pupski's always right, to be fair.
I don't care. I don't care what other people think.
These two commentators are Mark Lunn and Danny Byrne. That's it, really. That's all I can say. Mark Lunn's sober, Danny Byrne isn't. That's a nice shot. Nah, but look, dry break, you are right. This is not Lee's usual stand. But he's never ended up behind that, has he? He's ended up right behind that. That's a little bit unfortunate for me. He didn't need to go that far, though, Mark. So it's a poor shot. It's a very poor shot.
Eaton knows the score. Better than Virgo. Yeah, I'd actually be insulted if you said we weren't as good. Weren't better than them two.
Now, I'll agree that was a poor shot from Lee. He didn't have to go that far there.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, he has.
He's played a few
loose shots, and he'll agree with that. And that's probably why the scoreline isn't a little bit closer. I still think Jack would be in front, but if Lee had cut out them couple of silly errors.
Yeah, Jack really hasn't missed much, Mark, and there's nothing.
He hasn't, but then again, Lee hasn't missed a great deal. He's just run out of position.
That's true.
I
don't know what he's looking at here, but it's not conducive to a good result for Lee.
No.
Whatever it is.
He's put the yellow.
This
put the yellow.
Sort of half tied a ball. Jack can play it first. He doesn't have to. He's not. Jack's not missing these, Mark.
No, mate. I totally agree. Oh, he's come too far on that.
He's gone too far, yeah. Oh, he's all right, Mark. He's all right.
Oh, it still
goes.
He's
absolutely perfect, isn't
it? Still goes, yeah. Bit of a loose one, though.
Yeah,
we haven't seen many from him.
When it set off, it didn't look the best. But it's turned all right, okay.
Right, we've got rid of all the stupidness from the chat now. We can have a normality.
2010 is very tough to come back from. We both know that.
It is, mate, no doubt. To 25. Whoa, is it the near draw?
Do you know what, Mark? He's had an absolute roll there with that red not going in.
Well, no, because if the red goes in, the white doesn't catch the jaw, I don't think.
So does Asbo play safe here? Just flick off the yellow?
Unless he wants to pot it and play with screwing right hand side and get back on it, then no.
If it's not touching the yellow, Mark, he can go off the cushion in behind it, can't he? And he can move it a fair bit if he wants to make it a much easier pot. Someone in the chat say Mark Lundvig Gabin's gonna.
Well, that's ever gonna happen.
Yeah.
One, because I'm a machine, and to be fair, I'd win. And secondly, I don't like the game, so I won't get out of bed for less than at least $2,000.
Now,
and three.
People chucking Gabe's name around.
Gabe hasn't said that, so why are people saying it?
Mark, you and I both know Gabe is an absolutely lovely bloke.
He's a sound lad, yeah. Great
lovely
guy.
Bloke.
Great guy. Bag of beef monster munch. Yeah, I can't afford your steaks, mate. Can't afford your steaks, Taylor 110. Beef monster munch.
Lee's going for this, Mark.
Big shot this time. He's nailed it.
He deserves the credit for that. It's a nice shot, is that? It's a nice shot.
In the status of the match, that's big. I mean, 19. I know 1911. Lee's still not in the game, but 2010 is definitely not in the game.
No, he's not. He needs to just flick the red here. Just hit it, maybe full in the face. Yep, just like that. Just like that. Drink time, Lonnie. Would you like one?
Another big break from Jack. It's been the story all night long. Jack's break has been far superior to that of Lee's tonight.
Come on, Lee.
Oh, what a great shot from Jack. Knew he couldn't hold it, so he's elected to play into the red, and he's just come out smelling of roses. What a fantastic shot. So I think he's straight enough here that he can just screw back and play the black in the left middle. He's just looking at that angle now to make sure it goes. Played it perfect. Oh, he's missed it. Wow. Caught the yellow on the way in. To play a tricky black here. That'd have been my last ball, to be honest, to be able to get perfect on the black. But he's decided to go a different way. He may have elected to just cannon this out slightly towards the middle. He's playing for the double. It's a pretty big bag. I'm not sure he's come far enough though. No, he has. It's fine. You can tell from that side angle. Hit it pretty firm, straight. Looks to be going on the bottom rail, is it? No. It's a gift for Mr. Whelan. Jack just waiting for the chance to quieten down before he plays his shot. Fair enough. He's nailed it. 2011.
Sabbatical there. It's been going off.
Lee had a fairly simple finish.
Elected
Lee. Elected to double the black when he could have cannoned it out and missed the double. And Jack potted it.
Not a great idea then.
Personally, I'd have cannoned it out, but there we go.
Fair play, fair play.
2011. Jack just needs five.
I have to be honest, Mark. Some of his decisions so far have been, from what I've seen, pretty poor. Pretty poor. Lee makes balls on the break, and I fully expect a break this year on Reds.
Yeah, big break that, mate.
Very good break there. I'd like to point out, Mark, that, you know, a few people at early doors in the chat were saying that the table didn't look cracking. Spoke to Ben Clayton, who lost earlier on. And I said to him, Ben, how was the table? And he went, honestly, I were expecting maybe a little bit of criticism. He said, the best I've ever played on by a country mile. He said, obviously, he's played down at Ossett, he's played down at Ralph's place in Players in Rotherham. And he said, the tables down there are all absolutely fantastic. He said, but halfway through the match, he spoke to Ralph. And he said, Ralph, this table, different class. That's all I need to say about that. Thank you.
Lee can stroke this in. Top it through about 2 feet. Should be okay.
Yeah.
For a break dish.
That'll do nicely, Mark. Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a massive confidence booster from the last frame. Definitely, mate. From what you told me.
Break dish.
Break and run there, Jerry. Break dish on yellows. Break dish on reds, it doesn't really matter. Jack will break dish them. Eric Doherty asking if I'm pissed in the chat room.
Most certainly.
Maybe.
Most certainly.
Yeah, I've had a few.
Most certainly.
I've had a few. Confirming if I'm pissed or not, but I've had a couple.
Jack hasn't rock dished in a while.
I'm disappointed Doherty's not here with us, Mark. I
know, he's let us down, hasn't he? He's let side down.
Do you know what, Mark? I think we could have maybe implemented a third microphone for that, don't you?
Yeah, we could, definitely.
If you ever fancy joining us, Doherty, there's a third microphone with your name on it, son.
They're asking you if you fancy a bum.
Ah, I'd love a bum.
Toffee apples at the ready.
Mark, do you want to click player A plus one and break dish? Yes, now.
Yeah, to be honest with you, I think Lee's shot choice has a few of his like black ball specific shots have let him down tonight. He's done it a couple of times where he's had a skill shot and he ain't gone for it. He's had that shot I mentioned where he could have just dropped it over the pocket and burned his first visit.
Without a doubt, Mark, it's.
I don't know whether that's pressure or.
It seems daft to say that someone who's been so good at the game for the last sort of. I mean, look at this. I mean, you know, they were sort of quite simple, and Jack's making them look very, very easy. Whereas when Lee gets a finish like that, Mark, he's making them look quite tough, isn't he?
Yeah,
and
it's just not been Lee's night tonight.
It hasn't
simple
been
as that.
Lee's night, and obviously, Mark, it's the worst night for it not to be Lee's night. Let's be honest.
Yeah.
It couldn't be a worse night for it not to be Lee's night. But he's still got his fans behind him, Mark. So anything can happen. Yeah, as Seaside Pool says in the chat, you know, and I spoke to Lee about this, he's having a nightmare. You know, Lee beat Lee Clough, who's, if we're being completely honest, Mark, is in the top three players in the world right now on the IPA Tour. And he beat him in the Blackpool singles final, first to seven, and missed one ball. So that tells you all you need to know about Lee.
Yeah, but I also agree with Driver 81 that it is a run, only a short race.
Oh, absolutely, Mark. I wouldn't.
And the pressure for cash is massively different.
Without doubt. I wouldn't. I mean, you know, I don't like to bring this up, Mark, but I beat you a couple of weeks ago, 5-3.
You love to bring it up, don't lie.
I do love to bring it up. But, however, I wouldn't fancy beating you first to 15.
No.
Not at all. No way.
I wouldn't fancy you beating me first to 15.
No, I wouldn't fancy beating you. And that's God's honest truth. You know. Mark, that's not because I aren't confident in myself. That's because I know you're better than me. Simple as that.
Yep.
I've been very impressed with Jack tonight, Mark. No, Damien Cooper is probably right in the chat room. I won't beat him up to 10. No, very, very right again. I've been.
Do you know what? Right, people say I'm big-headed and I'm arrogant or not.
He's not big-headed.
I'm just confident. I just know.
He knows.
You know your own ability, don't you?
Meh. He knows. I know he's bloody good and all. But
I'm not as good as these guys. I'm not as good as these guys.
No, Mark, I'll agree with you. You're not as good as these guys.
I know where I stand.
Especially not as good at Jack at nine ball, but you know. You might be now. You might be now. Not when I backed you, though, dickhead.
Oh, what about rest at six games that I won?
Yeah, well, I won't mention them.
Do they not matter? Lose two, win eight, and all of a sudden you remember your losses.
Allegedly not. After last night, I lost one. I've won you loads.
No, you aren't. You're rubbish.
What? Sorry, what?
Not big-headed, just big-eared.
Sorry, what? I don't like the cue ball position there, do you?
It's another bread dish for Lee if this goes in. Oh, it's just stayed up.
The cue ball position, Mark, were absolutely essential. Everything for short and nothing for long.
Yeah.
Now, everything for short, nothing for long there, Mark.
Definitely.
That were long, I'm afraid.
Yeah.
Well, Jack's finally missed the ball. Mark, I'm not being funny, but if that bottom ball goes in the middle, then that's an absolutely ridiculous shot.
No, that don't go. That don't go.
Oh my word. Right then.
It's a good effort.
Cracking effort.
But now Lee's massive favourite for this frame.
However, Mark, there is always the option of a skill shot.
Yeah, but Lee's still a big favourite in my opinion.
Oh, of course he is. I'm going to agree with Seaside Pool in the chat and yeah, say that Jack has probably brought his practice game tonight. Jack has literally how many balls would you say he's missed? I'd say five maximum.
Yeah.
And
well, that's what I've always said, Danny. You know, you know, as like from practicing with me before, that I like to practice like I'm in a match.
Yeah.
And this is what Jack's done. He's practiced like he's in a match. So when he's in a match, it feels like practice. Do you know what I mean? It's give and take.
Earlier on when I went to brush the table, obviously when the players had a break, Jack sat there, couldn't hear a thing. He had his headphones in. That is focus, that, Mark. And that, you know what? That's not my style. But I'll tell you something. I've got to take my hat off, and I've got the utmost respect for every sort of pool player who's playing for this sort of money. You know me, Mark. I respect every pool player anyway, but someone who's sat there in the middle of a money game when he's just having a break, sat there, and you know his girlfriend's here, all his best friends are here, and he sat there with his earphones in, turning anybody away who's trying to speak to him. That to me speaks. Get out of my way. I'm winning this game. Get out of my way. I'm not losing this game. Shut up and piss off. To be honest. It's focus, Mark. You're right, that's the best word for it. It's focus, and Jack has got hell of a lot of focus. So I take my hat off to him, I really do. And to be honest, he's a good lad as well, he really is. You know, I met him face to face for the first time the other week. down in Pudsey. He seemed like a lovely guy. Met him tonight again, lovely bloke. Lee, I spoke to a lot more. I spoke to Lee a lot more than I spoke to Jack. While, you know, obviously while arranging the game, and Lee's a very genuine sort of down to earth sort of bloke. He loves a bit of banter. You know, he's a showman, is Lee. Whereas Jack's a bit more sort of refined. Lee was sort of asking, is there walk on music and all this? Can I bring my Superman cape? And that's genuine as well, Mark. Can I bring my Superman cape? I'm like, well, if you want some walk on music, Lee, we'll arrange that for you. We don't generally do it, but we'll arrange it. And they were like, no, it's okay. Not once did Jack ask that. He was just like, right, how much?
No, he's not bothered.
What time?
He's not bothered. He's sort of similar to me. Like, all he wants to do is just get the job done. Whatever that takes, just get the job done.
Yeah, of course. And let's be honest, Mark. If you're that good, turn up and play. Simple as that.
Lunny, who's Jack sticking his pecker up? What's the name?
Do you know what, Mark? If Unique really wants to know, I'll go outside and I'll... We have a guest commentator. What's your name, sir?
Craig. Waldron.
Craig Waldron. We have a guest commentator for one frame. Craig Waldron. It's alright, I'll let you in now. It'll cost you a pint though.
I don't want to be in now.
It'll cost you a pint though.
I don't want to be in this.
It'll cost you a pint.
You can wait a minute.
Guest commentator in with us.
Craig Waldron.
How you doing, Craig?
I'm all right. I'm all for Lee Anderson, though. I know he's 23-12 now. And you can hear the boys saying it. It's all about the Asbo. He's going to rack these balls up great, and he's going to dish. With my fellow commentator, what's your name?
Mark.
Lip AKR, when I get back to Blackpool, I'll play you, son. Let's have it. Jack Wheeler on his goal. Respect where it's due. How does Dope Tweet Fest comes up?
Is Craig hoping for a Tweet Fest?
Is that Pinder Seaside Pool? But with all respect,
Waldron, you neutrally says, "Are you a neutral? Are you a neutral commentator?"
I am not a neutral commentator. I want Lee Anderson to win. I am not going to lie, but give credit where credit's due to Jack Whelan.
Yeah, he's played well tonight.
He's
hasn't
played
he?
Very well. He's played great.
He's on for another break this year.
It's like said earlier on, when it's sat over there, it's over. I can't see him missing. It's over. And well played to him.
24-12, it looking like.
It's not time for bed for Craig. Once again, nice clearance.
He's played for it to the middle there, though, and he hasn't quite come far enough.
It should still be in, though.
Play it in the bottom bags, you think?
With all respect, he should get it. And once again, he doesn't miss.
Yeah, he's got it.
And once again, he does not miss.
He's on the hill.
I am going to go. I'm going to go back to the other guy, but in all respect, well played, Jack Wheeling.
On the break dish front, we have 8 for Mr. Whelan and just a 2 for Mr. Anderson. So Jack just needing the one more now. I think we'll hear Mr. Whelan's fans go absolutely mental if he wins this frame.
Yeah, Danny? Jack's on the hill, and we won't be too pleased with that, will they? Look at that.
I put Scott on by accident.
Idiot.
I put Scott up to 25.
How's he looking here?
He hasn't won yet. I was looking to be playing safe, but he's left Asbord.
Lee's got a chance of this.
To be honest, Danny, fairly easy finish.
Fairly easy finish, Matt, but 24-12 down.
It's not looking good for Asbord.
Nah, it's not looking great, mate. And, you know, I've been a big Asbo fan, me, all the way in the run up to this game. He's struggling from here, isn't he? He's struggling big time.
Yeah, I mean, we just had Craig in, and he's an Anderson fan, but he said I'll take me after Jack.
Oh, without a doubt.
He's been the better player on the night, no doubt.
Without a doubt. Now, without a doubt, Mark. Yeah. Jack has been by far the better player on the night, and as me and you both know, mate, on the night is what matters. It doesn't matter your pedigree, your previous results, none of that.
No, mate. Oh, and he's kissed it safe.
He's kissed it safe, and
I've never seen Jack move as quick getting his chalk out of his pocket. Then
that's probably lost it match, Matt. You agreed?
I think you're right, mate. Yeah.
And it's really unfortunate.
Even if he gets this red behind the black, he's going to be snookered, isn't he?
I don't think he's going to get it. Yeah, he's going to be snookered, which means Jack's going to play a black onto red. Once it gets 2 shots, obviously. I always feel for players, Mark, like I did earlier for Richard Pammant. I always feel for players who turn up and just give, like, oh, what a great shot.
What a great shot that is.
What a great shot.
He deserves a good respect there from Jack's fans.
A lot of respect from Jack's fans. That's well deserved.
There weren't a lot he could do there, to be fair.
No, there wasn't, and that's a cracking shot. What I need here is knowing off.
Yeah, that'd be awful.
And he's missed it, Mark. He's missed it, and
Jack's got a chance to close out the match here and now.
He has indeed. It isn't the easiest chance, is it, Mark? He's probably going to have to play a double first.
He's just apologised as Lee for getting a bit lucky there, to be fair.
Yeah.
I don't think the double goes either, Danny.
I think the double might go. However, I think Jack can play the double in such a way that if he just tops that double through, the white's not leaving a shot on the black. Agreed? If he puts it on the cushion, he's not exactly leaving swerve either, is he? Mark looks perplexed.
I don't see what Jack can do.
He can probably just dish
there's
these
no
up.
Point there's no point in playing safe because it's pretty easy swerve. I don't know.
Well, he's playing safe. I think he's left this black, mate. I think he's left this black.
He has.
He's definitely left the black, I mean.
Yeah, he's rubbing his head. He's definitely left this. 24.
In all honesty, Mark, it makes
30.
No difference.
Not really. Well, Lee's up again, back looking at it.
It makes no difference. Lee is not going to beat Jack. 13-0, is he?
No, in all honesty, no.
Hang on, he's back.
There we go, the Asbo son.
There we go, the Asbo son. Apparently.
So we've heard.
And now another breaking dish from the Asbo. Here we go.
Here we go.
Apparently there's a breaking dish from the Asbo coming up here.
Well, if he calls it, he's a genius. Well, a ball's gone in, Mark, so it's a possibility. For me, he's got to play the yellow onto the red now.
That geezer is getting some right stick
on
the chat.
He loves it. He's got to play yellow onto red, Mark, and he's got to hit this pretty hard.
Yeah, agreed.
How's his angle here? Oof.
Double the red across. In fact, Danny, you don't even have to do out with that. You can just pop this red in the corner and then you can play that red over the pocket and free the other red up later, so.
He's played it well, so Lee's on reds. I'm genuinely gutted for Lee. I mean, I'll take absolutely nothing away from Jack. He's been the better player by far. No one can dispute that, Mark.
No, 100%, mate.
But I am genuinely gutted for Lee because we both know what he's got to offer.
Yeah, we do. Yeah. And he knows he's got a lot more to offer. And Jack knows he's got a lot more to offer.
Mate. Jack took the game, obviously, knowing that he could win. But Lee took the game, Mark, knowing that he could win. And, well, it hasn't panned out the way that Lee wanted. It's panned out the way Jack wanted.
Eric Dockett is saying Whelan v. Wad. As far as I'm aware, Whelan and Wad are pretty good mates.
They are pretty good
so
mates.
So I don't think that game will ever happen.
Yeah, I don't think they'd play. I really don't think they'd play. If they wish to play.
No, he's never on the rail, that, were it? Never on the rail, that.
No, I've no one hit rail. If they wish to play.
Steve Oval on the chat, he's asking, how do we find out when the next match is streaming? It's pretty simple, mate. If you just go onto Facebook, if you signed up already, and just search for Molly International Money Games and just add yourself to that group, and everything we do money wise is all posted in there.
It's
so
on, it's on there, kid.
Just add yourself into there and
you'll
be the first to know.
We have actually got some cracking games coming up too, Mark. We have how I was Rob Wilson in the world, Mark? Top, he was top 16, wasn't he?
Not too sure, to be honest.
I think he was top 16, Mark. Rob Wilson against Jules Goodyear. I'll tell you what, Lee's had a bit of shape there. Oh, he's had... Is it that far too hard, Mark?
Game over, mate.
Yeah, without a doubt.
Unless he goes two or three rails and sticks up behind the black ear, it's game over.
Unless he can go to one rail and kick this in.
I think the yellow's too close to the rail.
I think the white's in off, innit?
The yellow's too close to the rail. I don't even think you can hit the black. Never mind pot it. I don't think you can hit this.
the one thing I can say from tonight's game, Mark, is that Lee Anderson...
You'll have to broadcast swearers.
He isn't going to be happy with his performance tonight.
Oh, he's got too much on it. I didn't think he could get that, but fair play. Well...
That Tower 72? Is that Lee Clough? Tower 72?
Jack is going to give himself a good roll here to get out. Going to give himself a good chance to get out here. Going to try canning these out by looks. Well, that's one of them. One down, two to go.
I think he can get this. He can get these off this ball in the middle.
Nailed it. Needs a bit of luck. He gets it. It's game over. Listen out for this.
Gentlemen, that is all she wrote.
If you haven't already...
Or is it?
Yeah, chill out. If you haven't already... Turn your volume down, because you're going to hear this. Mr. Whelan's fans are going to go nuts.
Shows absolutely no nerves, does he?
None whatsoever.
None at all. Game over. Cheers for coming. Thanks very much for watching, ladies and gents. Good night. Very, very mutual exchange of handshake there, Mark. Very sportsmanlike, and
yeah, the game was played in the spirit of the game between the players, and that's all that matters at the end of the day. Fair play to both. You know, Jack's obviously played the better player on the night. Lee's obviously struggled.
He was battered by the better player on the night. Let's be fair.
The best player won, and that's all she wrote. And
absolutely. Well, thanks, ladies and gents, for tuning in tonight and all day. We've had an absolutely awesome day, and to be honest, I'm genuinely gutted that we can't provide you with a much closer feature game. But what can you say, Jack? Out of this world tonight.
Yeah, 100%
and
agree.
Absolutely with fair play to him. Fantastic stuff. I'll go sort the money out with the guys.
Yep.
Good night, everyone.
Cheers for tuning in.